I think the most important thing is networking and the exchange of experiences. If you are a member of our organization, you have a network in more than 50 countries around the world. And also to, when you are talking about organizations like ours, people often think that we are kind of aid organization that give from the north to the south. And I think that's not the fact, because we are on the same level and we have so much to give each other on different areas. And also I think it's very important that women working practically within the media have this opportunity to exchange the experiences. And also we are trying to fund projects that we are doing together, like documentary films. And we are also we have also been able to give scholarship grants to some of our members. And also this year we have produced a handbook that is about safety for women journalists working in conflict areas. We are giving trainings in that area too. And I think this handbook will be very useful for women journalists actively working in conflict zones.
And do you think that your being a part of your organisation would encourage women to perhaps develop their careers, take on more senior positions in some way?
Yes, that's an area that we try to support as much as we can. We are often having workshops also addressing management issues and how to enhance equal opportunities within the broadcasters. But the nature of our members has changed a lot also over recent years, because from the beginning it was people who were employed at a bigger broadcaster, which maybe also had some money to spend on development and trainings, etc. But these days more and more of our members are freelancers working either on their own or with very small companies, broadcasters, with very little money. So we try to do good things for that kind of members too.